Wait, what? Something currently relevant and in this show's wheelhouse actually happened recently enough to do a show on? Like, for real? I can do something other than summarize a forgotten cartoon or explain why bewildering plot points from a 40-year-old comic book might be clues to the plot of a movie that doesn't come out for another 2 years? Alright, hey, fun! Let's do this! So Brian Griffin is dead, apparently. I'll be honest, guys, I totally forgot Family Guy was gonna kill a regular character this past Sunday. I tuned in because I was ironically working on what will now be a different episode of this show and wanted something on in the background other than what was, at the time, kind of a depressing football game. It got better. So, yeah, for those who weren't privy, at the midpoint of an otherwise kinda mediocre episode, with maybe one funny joke about denim jackets, Brian got hit by a car and died. Like, straight up, deathbed scene, funeral, the whole thing. The family gets sad, but then they buy a new talking dog, an Italian stereotype named Vinny, voiced by one-time Sopranos mainstay Tony Sirico. Everyone in the family likes him right away except Stewie, who ironically had just finished destroying the time machine that would have allowed them to fix this problem, but he comes around after Vinny gives him a heart-to-heart about moving on, and that's really it. Brian stays dead, Vinny is the new dog, apparently. Alright, let's get right to it. This almost definitely has to be a joke, right? A scheme, a way to get the show talked about during the Thanksgiving break so that when it comes back on December 8th, they can turn it into either a one-off or a recurring joke. The signs are all there. The episode itself isn't very funny or memorable, even by the standards of present-day Family Guy. From an animation standpoint, Vinny's design doesn't look like something they thought all the way through, and character-wise, there isn't much immediately apparent to be wrung out of his interactions with the other characters, especially Stewie. What makes this especially suspicious is that Vinny, with apologies to those involved if this turns out not to be a joke, seems like a pretty terrible one-joke character. Also worth raising an eyebrow over, this is happening in relative vicinity to the show's upcoming crossover with The Simpsons, the show that turned Dog with an Attitude into animation fandom shorthand for bad new character. And yes, I'm aware of that old and since walked back quote from Seth MacFarlane that he wants the audience to lose interest in the show so it can end already, but I don't buy that this is sabotage. This is the kind of stunt that generally makes a show's ratings go up, once they change it, and then again when they change it back. On the other hand, let's say they were to simply start up the next episode with Brian back and everyone acting like nothing happened, followed by a fourth wall break or a meta cutaway, making fun of TV shows that pull crap like this for real, and or making fun of audiences who actually got legitimately upset about this on social media and then everything goes back to normal. Or if they waited a month and did that, that'd be kind of funny, but it'd also feel really out of place. Longview series continuity swipes are more of an American Dad joke, though if we're really being honest here, any variation of killing Brian for good would actually be closer to a South Park joke. Killing or otherwise writing off characters from episodic TV shows used to be a big deal because the rule of thumb was that actors who weren't major movie stars wanted TV gigs for the steady employment. When Shelley Long left Cheers, it was a big deal because everyone assumed she was going to be a movie star, but then wasn't. See also David Caruso exiting NYPD Blue. And it was a huge thing when Suzanne Summers was gradually working her way out of Three's Company, since she was the two reasons people watched that show. And of course, killing Maude Flanders on The Simpsons was a milestone because animated shows especially were supposed to be immune to mortality. But most importantly of all, killing off characters used to be a big deal because American TV was consumed in a fundamentally different way up until very recently, i.e. shows were designed primarily to be watched the first time they aired and then potentially never again. So when they said, hey, tune in, something important's gonna happen, you did because it was probably gonna be it. That's also why a vast majority of shows wrapped up individual storylines in self-contained episodes, because you couldn't count on people always watching. But now in the age of Netflix streaming and DVD binging, more and more shows are serialized, and big definitive moves are telegraphed way in advance and designed to be potentially undoable in the next round if it becomes necessary, especially since it's become more of a risk now that the internet has supercharged the ability of sub-fandoms to maintain themselves, and people's attachment to certain characters can take on a life of their own. I mentioned South Park earlier mainly because they had a stretch of several seasons where they were breaking out of their own mold just for the hell of it. Remember Mr. Stick, Ms. Choksondik, the Marshes breaking ups, Kenny staying dead, trying to recruit a new fourth for the team, all that business? Eventually, it seemed like even they found the reliability of formula TV to be hard to fully break, but the impossibility of managing an audience they had learned right away. Way back at the beginning of that series, they did an episode about Cartman looking for his unknown father, remember that one? Which ended on a cliffhanger, time to wrap up on April Fool's Day, and instead preempted by an intentionally terrible Terrence and Phillip special. They built the fake-out plot around Cartman specifically because they'd created him to be unlikable and unrelatable, so nobody would care about his resolution. Except they did. Ironically, the writers had done too good a job on the fake-out. Fans were legitimately invested in Cartman's story, and instead of enjoying the show's joke at the expense of manufactured plot twists, they were furious at not getting their answer, ultimately leading Parker and Stone to put together a real resolution later on, which wound up being one of the early season's better installments. Well, for the sake of the folks with careers invested in Family Guy, I kinda hope that's what's going on here, a somewhat misfire joke that won't last long, because even if it'd be charitable at best to call the Griffins and their friends characters at this point, if they think most of their audience is similarly meta enough enough to regard killing Brian and replacing him with a bad new character to be a sustainably funny Andy Kaufman-esque anti-comedy joke in and of itself? Well, I have a feeling they're in for a rude awakening if Sunday's social media feeds were any indication. Or maybe they're just clearing the deck. The show is getting another shakeup in the near future when it reabsorbs the main supporting cast of the now-concluded Cleveland show back into the stable. Maybe the Brian-Stewie team needed to get shut down to try Stewie with Rollo or Cleveland Jr. Or maybe not. There's at least two supposedly confirmed episodes in the near future whose titles imply Brian will be around, so who knows? Either way, it should be interesting to see this unfold. For now, this is the writing off or death of one of the major characters on what is, like it or not, a pop culture institution. Even now, you don't see that every day. I'm Bob, and that's The Big Picture.